Ladies and gentlemen, our next fight is a title fight, a bantamweight title fight. Fighting out of the red corner, representing Torres MMA, please welcome to the octagon, Kieran Brady! Hey, hey, hey.
This is the blues I'm playing. Yeah, no. Yeah. Yes, it's a final thing. Whirl that reggae music when the night is cold and low. Keep me rocking with me, Dasha.
And his opponent fighting in the blue corner, representing C-Mac Mixed Martial Arts, please welcome to the cage, Jordan Bradshaw!
Our bantamweight title bout is underway, and Jordan Bradshaw, very experienced amateur in the brighter green trunks, finds himself on his back here. Kieran Brady, the 7-2 record himself, also a relatively experienced grappler. Bradshaw, of course, had 12 fights in 2022, unbelievably productive. He's had two already this year at the IMAP Worlds. He's a busy guy and wants to rack up a lot of experience before venturing into the professional ranks. Finds himself on his back here. Brady 7-2 record. He won his opening five bouts, picked up a couple of losses to good level opponents in Elvis Lucco and Cara McConway, but then he's had two wins since, so victorious more often than not. He's working hard to get to the back of Bradshaw here. Dumps him down to the mat beautifully. The Team Torres man, he's establishing in some good positional dominance. Almost takes the back. Just gets the one hook for now. Maybe a little high as he hears. Is he going to slide off? Bradshaw trying to tripod up, and just a little shake might be enough if he can just stay on his feet. But the weight of Kieran Brady maybe breaking down that posture. Maybe he has the one hook in, then one around the outside of the hip. Don't know if it's going to give him enough grip to stay on the back here. If Bradshaw can just stay calm, patient, he might just be able to shimmy his opponent off. Looks like he's ever so slowly sliding down. Doesn't really have a secure seatbelt, and his chest is more towards the back of the neck rather than completely on the back. So yeah, you can just see he's starting to slide down. What Brady needs to do here is possibly post that right hand on the mat and push himself backwards so they can drop to their backsides, and then he'd be able to secure a much better position. He's got the left one in as an underhook, so he can't release that. Rolls forward instead, and now he's able to establish a far better back mount position. But he only had the one hook, so he wasn't able to secure it fully. Really good work from Bradshaw. Good patient recovery. But that arm might still be trapped inside. He needs to go with him rather than trying to slide out here. He does so beautifully. Good calm composure in a precarious position.
Oh, he's looking at the razor lock. Yeah. Oh, he slipped out.
Yeah, Brady is just threatening non-stop, but there comes a point now when you go through these sort of transitions that you find yourself on your back with your opponent raining down shots. You eventually realise you've lost your control and position. But he manages to make it back to his feet, and Bradshaw gets a chance now to let the hands go. Big kick to the body. One's returned, and a good opening round. Kieran Brady would be very happy with some of the grappling exchanges there. He seemed to manage to get better positional control and establish some good attacks from there. Bradshaw taking some big deep breaths in that corner. As we said, two of the more experienced fighters with winning records on this card, and they're fighting for the Chaos Bantamweight title. Big deep breaths being taken from both sides. Kieran Brady shaking out his arms. Bradshaw looks to have recovered quite well after being sucking a little bit of air at the end of that first round. And very, very close first one in the books. We've got to see what round two brings. Nice straight left to the body, and Bradshaw goes back to the well again. Then up top, good mixing up with the shots. Slips back and comes back in with a left hand. Starting to get comfortable now, throwing shots. Brady tries to enter, tries to get to that takedown attempt. Bradshaw reverses him well. Not much between these two guys so far. Brady manages to just ragdoll Bradshaw to the floor. Bradshaw has 5 submission victories to his name so far. Brady with just the one.
Brady's on the back again.
Yeah. He's looked very threatening in the grappling exchanges so far. And that wrist control is making life very difficult for Bradshaw.
Is he on the neck, Paul? No.
I don't think so. I think he has the right arm just clinching on the wrist. So he's underneath the armpit and bite down on the wrist at the moment. There's just a bit of grip fighting going on, a bit of wall walking going on. Both guys trying to establish a better position here. Bradshaw needs to get his back to the floor. Most importantly, he needs to continue fighting those grips at the moment. Yeah, he's doing the right thing, trying to drive backwards and drive up high. And instead of turning to go to his hands there, he needed to maybe slide outwards and get his back to the ground and then scramble from there. Brady's trying to turn that into a back mount again. He's a little off to the side though. But this again looks like that position we saw in the first round. He's very high, in danger of sliding off. There might be a Sulev stretch here. You know that knee bar submission that Aljamain Sterling picked up in the UFC a few years back? It's always there as an option when you end up in this too high back mount and your opponent postures up with that, or tripods up with their hips in the air, and you can catch an arm on the way out, which he's thinking about too, but doesn't seem to have the bite on it. But he's off to the side here. If Bradshaw can posture up, he'll be safe, and he does so. He needs to make sure he doesn't get an arm trapped on the way out. He has the opportunity now to start working a pass. get that knee free. He can drop it down to the near side or the far side. He elects for the far, which gives Brady the chance to recover a guard in the scramble. Big shots there with the left hand by Bradshaw. Needs to posture up and start landing some damaging blows, because the grappling prowess of Brady has probably been the defining factor over the first two rounds. Good sprawl by Jordan Bradshaw. Gets a chance to go to the back himself now. Flipping the script completely.
That's on.
He's tight on the neck.
Short choke. Oh, no, he's not.
Just wasn't enough. But he really has Kieran Brady struggling here. And he's on it again.
He must have heard you about the grappling exchanges.
Yeah. He's oh. He turned that round on its head. And for my money, landed much more damaging blows and submission attacks in that last 30 seconds than Kieran Brady did in the first 2.5 minutes. So he may well have nicked that round out of nowhere. Fight's on.
Yep.
Woo! The belt up for grabs, and the whole fight could be up for grabs going into round number three. And now Bradshaw's team, Ross Querny and Alexander O'Sullivan, telling them to look across the cage. And just notice how tired Kieran Brady is looking, because he went all in on a couple of back attacks and didn't really get anywhere, any result.
Owen.
So it's a big third round in store. The title's up for grabs here. Brady trying to shake out those legs. When you're on someone's back like that, in that weird upside down position, it's a very draining clinch hold. And Bradshaw looks fresh now. That little bit of success he had near the end of round number two seems to have just energized him. Again, just like the start of the last round, he's trying to get the boxing going. Get that left hand, get that jab going. And is he able to fight off the clinch of Kieran Brady? This time he is. Brady tries again to get a body lock. Bradshaw reverses him. Gets double unders. He might be just winning the fatigue battle here. He might be the one with a little bit more in the tank as we go down the final stretch.
And you just feel, Paul, that this round dictates where the belt's going.
I think it could well be, because I think Bradshaw had more success in his short period of dominance at the end of round two than Brady had in his longer period of dominance. But so, oh, a slip as Bradshaw throws that straight left. The southpaw against orthodox, that rear hand shot is the most dangerous weapon. He needs to get an underhook and start to sprawl, but he elects to go for that sweep. It's a gamble in a mixed martial arts setting. Jay listens to his corner. Alexander O'Sullivan called for him to get on top instead of staying there in that side beside where anything can go wrong in a scramble. He now goes on the attack, and this could be the defining moment of the fight. If he can finish out this round laying down these attacks, landing some damaging blows and maintaining positional dominance, it could be what gets him over the line and gets that belt wrapped around his waist. Big sprawl needed here. Kieran Brady wrestles up very well. He's digging deep, getting in on that high crotch and trying to hoist up Jordan Bradshaw. Bradshaw trying to sprawl and trying to drag that left heel back. Massive battle of wills here. Connects the hands. Is he going to get that one last big, big takedown? Dumps Bradshaw to the floor. What a roller coaster ride of a third round. Bradshaw gets the feet back in between him and his opponent and kicks him away temporarily. Kieran Brady, just out of desperation and fatigue, drives his opponent in against the fence. Is he going to connect the hands yet again? He's gone for that single this time. Bradshaw trying to, he thought momentarily about the Kimura grip. Gets that underhook, and that underhook could be vital. It could be what saves his bacon here. Needs to drive those underhooks upwards. Loses it, goes to the single, does Brady. The ebb and flow of this third round is unbelievable. Bit of fatigue here, but both fighters throwing, and that left hand of Bradshaw has landed on a few occasions here. It's getting wild. That big kick lands as Brady enters. Bradshaw crooked to the floor.
I can't call it.
Woo! I'm glad I don't have to judge this one. That was an absolute battle of a third round. It was up for grabs going into that third. And that just went back and forth over the entirety of that round. So, God bless the judges. They got a tough one on their hands for that one.
Give it up for two warriors, ladies and gentlemen. This fight was decided by a split decision. And the new bantamweight champion in the red corner, Kieran Breeze.